Dear students, our today's topic is the Tughlaq dynasty. Tughlaq dynasty was another dynasty which established its rule over Delhi Sultanate. After the end of the rule of Khilji, Tughlaqs established their hold over Delhi Sultanate. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq founded the Tughlaq dynasty in 1320 CE. Or Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq was the founder of Tughlaq dynasty. He was an experienced warrior, statesman, and an able administrator. He liberated various harsh measures imposed by Alauddin Khilji. After liberating those harsh measures, he restored peace and order in the kingdom. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq was succeeded by his son, Prince Junah Khan. After his succession, Prince Junah Khan became Muhammad bin Tughlaq, or he was popularly known as Muhammad bin Tughlaq, or that is the title which was given to him after his coronation. He became an outstanding ruler of Tughlaq dynasty. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was well known for his administrative experiments or reforms. He introduced various changes in military, economy, and also in administration. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was one of the most and extraordinary monarchs that have ever sat upon the throne of Delhi. He was an extraordinary monarch who ruled over Delhi Sultanate. Muhammad bin Tughlaq was a strange combination of good and bad. Means here he had both good and bad qualities. Or his personality or his character is a mixture of both good and bad qualities. As his character was complex and contradictory, he has been described as a mixture of two opposites. Means he had both good and bad qualities. That is mixture of two opposites. And sometimes some historians or scholars also described him as a mad king because of his experiments or reforms. His religious attitude and theory of kingship. In Delhi Sultanate, Muhammad bin Tughlaq was the first ruler who was liberal and tolerant in his religious attitude. He was not a blind follower of the words of ulemas. He never accepted any proposal of the orthodox Muslims without proving it by logic. Means he was not influenced by any religious authorities or ulemas. As a result, the position of the ulemas was reduced because of the religious policy of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. The position of orthodox Muslims or ulemas was reduced and they became bitter critics of the Sultan. On the other hand, Muhammad bin Tughlaq had very cordial relations with the Khalifa. He adopted a liberal and tolerant policy towards the Hindus. He was a religious tolerant ruler. He had also held religious discussions with the Hindu yogis and Jains. Then we have administrative reforms or experiments of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Muhammad bin Tughlaq is always well known for his experiments in administration. He was well known for his reforms, following where various reforms which are introduced by Muhammad bin Tughlaq or his experiments. First, revenue reforms, reforms in the field of revenue department. Soon after the assumption of power, Muhammad bin Tughlaq began to take keen interest in administration. He paid special attention to revenue administration because he wanted to increase the income of the state. He paid special attention to the revenue administration. He ordered compilation of the register of revenue and expenditure of the provinces of his empire. This helped him to have full idea about the income and expenditure of the state. Then his reforms in the field of agriculture or agricultural reforms. Mohammad Tughlaq established a special department of agriculture known as Diwan-i-Koi. Diwan-i-Koi means special agricultural department, which was established by Muhammad bin Tughlaq. After establishing agricultural department, he also appointed an agricultural officer called Amir-i-Koi. Amir-i-Koi was agricultural officer appointed by Muhammad bin Tughlaq. The main objective of the department was to bring more land under cultivation. He wanted to bring more land under cultivation because to increase the revenue of the state or income of the state. He also wanted to improve agriculture because agriculture was the main source of the income, or that is the main occupation of the people. So he selected a large tract of land and tried to sow different crops by rotation. It is said that he set apart 70 lakhs of tankas for this purpose. He also offered incentives to the officers in return for good results. Unfortunately, the land selected for this experiment was non-fertile. When Mohammad Tughlaq introduced these changes or reforms in the agriculture, he had good intentions. But unfortunately, the land which was selected for that purpose was not fertile, or that is not rich land, that is lacked that qualities of fertile land. So agricultural experiment proved a failure. He spent so much of money, or 70 lakhs of tankas for this purpose, but result is negative. So this plan is also failed. Then after agricultural reforms, he also introduced another reform, that is increase of taxes in Tawab region. This is another experiment of Mohammed bin Tughlaq, that is increase of taxes in Tawab region with a view to raise additional finances to organize an efficient system of administration. Mohammed bin Tughlaq increased taxes in Tawab region. The area between the river Ganges and the Yamuna is known as Doab region, that is known for its fertility. The area between the river Ganges and Yamuna is called as Doab region, and that is very fertile. It is very fertile area, so Mohammed Tughlaq decided to increase taxes in the Doab region to enhance the revenues of his empire. Unfortunately, this measure was carried out at the time when a severe famine was prevailing in the Doab. When Mohammed Tughlaq increased taxes in the Doab region during that time, the people of that area were suffered from a severe famine. So this is also result in the failure of this experiment of Mohammed bin Tughlaq. When he increased taxes in the Doab region, the distress of the people was greatly aggravated by its disastrous effect. Because of the effects of a famine, people were suffered heavily, and at the same time, Mohammed bin Tughlaq also decided to increase taxes in that region. So people's condition was miserable. when reformers were unable to pay, they were ruthlessly punished. This measure made Muhammad bin Tughlaq very unpopular. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮೊಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಬಿನ್ ತುಗ್ಲಕ್, ತುಗ್ಲಕ್ ಡೈನಾಸ್ಟಿ ಒಬ್ಬ ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧ ದೊರೆ, ಆದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಎಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧನಾಗಿದ್ದನ್ನ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಒಂದು ಏನ್ ಪಡಿತಾನೆ, ಅನೇಕ ಅವನ ತಂದಂತಹ ಅವನು ಒಂದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಏನು ಆಡಳಿತಾತ್ಮಕ ಸುಧಾರಣೆಗಳಿಂದಾಗಿ ಅವನು ತನ್ನ ಹೆಸರಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಕಪ್ಪು ಚುಕ್ಕೆಯನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಪಡಿತಾನೆ. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಮಾಡದೆ ಅಥವಾ ಸರಿಯಾದ ಒಂದು ಆಲೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಕೀಮ್ಸ್ ಗಳನ್ನು ಅಥವಾ ಅದನ್ನ ಏನು ಪ್ರಯೋಗಗಳನ್ನ ತರ್ತಾನೆ. ಸೊ ಅದರ ಒಂದು ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಇಫೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಯಾರ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ, ಜನರ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೋಗ್ತದೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನು ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಥವಾ ಕೃಷಿ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಧಾರಣೆ ತರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬಯಸ್ತಾನೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ ಸಿಗುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಯಾಕೆಂದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಅವನ ಕೃಷಿಯ ಒಂದು ಏನು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ಗೆ ಬಳಸಿದ ಭೂಮಿಯ ಫಲವತ್ತತೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರುವುದಿಲ್ಲ. ನಂತರ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಕಂದಾಯವನ್ನು ಇದು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕೆಂಬ ಉದ್ದೇಶದಿಂದ ದೋವಾ ಪ್ರಾಂತ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ ತೆರಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ವಿಧಿಸ್ತಾನೆ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಅವನು ಯಾವಾಗ ತೆರಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ವಿಧಿಸ್ತಾನೆ ನೋಡಿ, ಅದೇ ಸಂದರ್ಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರಗಾಲ ಬಂದಿರ್ತದೆ, ಜನರು ತತ್ತರಿಸಿ ಹೋಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ಯಾವುದನ್ನು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರೇಷನ್ ಗೆ ತಕೊಳ್ಳದೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತೆರಿಗೆಯನ್ನು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾನೆ, ಅದರಿಂದ ಕೂಡ ಜನರಿಗೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಈ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಕೂಡ ಫೇಲ್ಯೂರ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವೇರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಮುಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಬಿನ್ ತುಗ್ಲಕ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ದೋವಾಬ್ ರೀಜನ್ ವೇರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಫೇಲ್ಡ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅದರ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮುಹಮ್ಮದ್ ಬಿನ್ ತುಗ್ಲಕ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಿಟಲ್.